KEYNOTE-189 was a phase 3 trial, randomized chemotherapy plus pembrolizumab to chemotherapy. And it already proven the benefit in terms of overall survival, progression-free survival, response rate irrespective by PD-L1 status. In the recent years, there were some evidence suggesting that the tumor mutational burden on blood and on tissue could be relevant for the selection for a treatment with anti-PD-1, anti-PD-L1, and anti-PD-L1 and anti-CTL4. No data until now were available for the combination of chemotherapy and immunotherapy. So the objective of my presentation is the predictive value of tumor mutational burden assessed with whole exome sequencing in the chemotherapy and immunotherapy. The results presented were done in two different types. One was TMB was analyzed as a continuous variable, and there is no benefit in terms of overall survival, progression-free survival, and response rate in using this as a continuous variable. But we presented also data with two different cutoffs. One was 150 mutation per exome, and the other one was 175. And for both levels, there is no benefit by using the TMB for selecting patients for chemotherapy and immunotherapy. You can achieve exactly the same benefit in terms of overall survival, progression-free survival, and response rate for TMB high and TMB low. So for the selection of chemotherapy and immunotherapy, TMB seems not so useful.